Way, who recently published his first book after 8 good years. So now we just want to ask him, Way, like, what made you finally publish your book after 8 good years? And why did it take you that long? What pushed you? What was your motivation to finally publish? And maybe you can even tell us something about the book.
The novel is titled Listen Lines. So behind the story of the book is also the story of the many struggles that I went through as a writer and an author. And throughout this journey, I faced many challenges. Many people had let me down. There were so many challenges that I faced in the publishing journey. But then throughout all this, my book had gone through a transition phase. I had learned how sometimes delays are not meant to break you, but to build you up. And how certain things come in to actually shape your book. My book was actually shaped in so many ways through this 8-year delay that I went through. And interacted with so many authors. I had interacted with so many people who had actually helped to shape my book into something that I believe would be worthwhile, something that I believe would be quoted by many prominent people. And 6 to 7 years from now, I believe that that book will still be on the shelves.
Okay, and the last time I talked to you, you said your book is sold out, right?
Yes.
So the question is, was it intentionally a wait, or maybe it was circumstances that led to you waiting for the 8 years? What really?
It was circumstance, but then again, the circumstance, I actually call it a blessing in disguise, because it really helped, again, because the book that came out, if I look at the original manuscript, I'm so proud that it turned out to be something that can actually sell out. Many people are willing to sacrifice everything that they can to get their hands on this material and also share it with other people as well.
So, from what you're saying, I'm hearing that it's important for us to wait. You know, I'm sure you have tried to just produce it anyway as fast as you could, but you managed to wait until the season was ready and the book actually came out. So, are you doing any other writings? Are you working on another book?
There is another book. I won't really say when it's coming out or what it's about, but then all I can say is if you think that the first book was phenomenal, what's coming later on is going to be something big. And I do believe that with every project, there should be a step up in my creativity and my writing. And this is because there's a level and a standard of writing that I believe that some writing can be at.
That's very inspiring. So what made you write this book? Is it passion that you always had? Is it something to do with your upbringing, your background? Like, what really made you just finally write and publish your book?
Partially my upbringing. I was raised by a father who was really strict about reading culture. What I was exposed to growing up, I'd seen so much. And then something that my mentor also had said about the industry and also society itself. He said, if you think that there is a problem in society, what exactly are you doing to make an impact or to change it? So there are so many things that I said are wrong in the society, but then now I take a step up and I'm saying, let me show the world that I have a solution for society and I can bring something positive out of it.
Okay, so what exactly was the whole message, or maybe a summary of Bliss and Blindness?
Bliss and Blindness in totality is literally a book that questions most of the things that we are falling for. Most of the things that we say we're passionately in love with, hence the term bliss. But then how many things are we so in love with that have led to us having blindness? So then we're so blind in love with so many passions, so many things that have led us to lose our focus. And then for me, literally, the question at the end of this is, what is our main focus? Is it these passions that are leading us blind, or is it God?
Thank you. So is there anything else that you'd like to say to someone, an encouragement?
An encouragement is never stop dreaming, never stop becoming the person who you are. Never stop believing in your talent. It may be something that may seem small to you, but then God has a great impact waiting upon you and upon your life. And I believe through every dream, once it's cemented, once it's put forward and you put passion in it, it's going to come forward. Because every dream may seem like an impossibility, may seem like a joke, but then to everything that is considered to be a joke, God considered it to be something great.
Thank you so much for featuring on Conversations with B. I hope someone has learned something, and to you that is waiting to publish a book, I'm sure everything will work out. Keep writing those words, keep getting inspiration, keep believing, keep hoping, and eventually please let us read your work, publish it, and help someone learn from what you have to say about your